My name is Dan Banga. I lead our business development effort for a machine learning platform at AWS. Today, I want to talk about momentum. Momentum, the way I understand it and the way I define it, is the capacity for you and your business to leverage your scale and a certain velocity that is technically enabled by the cloud to move your business forward. And then to achieve some kind of momentum, you also need a couple of other constructs. And I factored that into accessibility and reproducibility. We are at the Jupyter conference. You probably heard a lot about reproducing science and research and all these practices. So I want to show you how we factor that in our thought processes as we build machine learning and AI platforms and technologies. So most of you know that machine learning technologies have been around for a while, but up until a few years ago, it was just these accessibility was just in the hands of a few developers with high performance computing capabilities or means. But today, with the cloud technologies providing super large infrastructures and packaging of solutions and technologies, it's actually possible for a lot of developers to get access to the same infrastructure, the same frameworks that only a few people had before. So much so that today we're seeing tens of thousands of developers actively developing machine learning products for test and production on top of AWS. And regarding the machine learning platforms at AWS, we're observing a 250% year-over-year growth. So there's just a humongous amount of people coming over to develop and deploy applications. And according to a Nucleus research, December 2017, 8 out of 10 machine learning workloads run on AWS today. And to talk about some of these folks, as you can see, I couldn't fit all of them on one slide there. We have people using machine learning, developing products with machine learning on AWS from startups to large enterprises. Some of them that are my personal favorites are ones like Duolingo, building language learning applications on top of AWS and localizing these language learning applications to multiple countries just because they can synthesize voices in multiple languages right away. You also have, if you're using ZocDoc, your insurance card is being analyzed using TensorFlow on AWS to extract the information out of that. And so we have customers from financial services as well, with customers like FINRA or other ones essentially processing financial data on top of AWS. And if you think about regulated environments like financial services or healthcare, you think about the scale at which we're thinking when we're building machine learning platforms. We also see a lot of advancement in sports analytics. Formula One is one of our recent customers. They've standardized around AWS for their machine learning platform capabilities. They ingest data from about 120 sensors in multiple cars during a race. And they've been doing that for more than 65 years. And all of that data set, they use a machine learning platform called Amazon SageMaker at AWS to analyze that. The way we use machine learning is in multiple areas of our businesses, in applied research, in core research. We publish a lot of papers in Alexa that I'm sure you guys are familiar with. We have multiple products that have machine learning injected in that. Robotics, natural language processing, you name it. Now, the goal for my team, the team that I work on, is to get all of that knowledge from the internal customers that we have, the Alexa, the Amazon.com, and all these other folks, and the external customers that we learn a lot from, and then bring that to the hands of the masses as in the forms of APIs and platforms and services. So we say our mission is to put machine learning in the hands of every developer and data scientist, and we're very serious when we say developer because we don't believe that you need to have a master's, bachelor, PhD in machine learning in order to be able to use the benefit of machine learning. If you can understand Python, if you can use Jupyter Notebooks, then you can use the machine learning platform on AWS to do machine learning. So to get back to the three pillars that I mentioned earlier, accessibility, reproducibility, and momentum. By accessibility, I mean bringing the machine learning platform and frameworks and pre-trained APIs and GPU and data and catalog access and all of these things that really power the machine learning capabilities into the hands of the people that have to use it. So if you think as an organization, how to make sure that your data is accessible, how to make sure that the infrastructure is accessible. And to reproduce, that's where Jupyter Notebooks comes in the picture. Well, you want to make sure you have SDKs and libraries and a lot of examples available. You have templates that are parameterized so that people can reuse these templates in order to solve the problems that they have. And you also want to think about units of packaging. How do you package algorithms? How do you package infrastructure? How do you package different profiles from the data scientist, the data engineer, the AI researcher? And how do you package the data? Because you have to make sure people can use some elements of your data set in order to reproduce the problems that you want them to have. And by momentum, I mean P is equal to MV. You thought math wouldn't come in this? But really, I like this because it shows how you can get the scale, as in the mass at which you operate, and the velocity together, and then push that forward as a business. And so the way we're thinking about it is by stacking all these packages into a few layers. At the bottom of the layers, we have the AI frameworks. And those are funny names like TensorFlow, MXNet, PyTorch, and Hoverboard, and all these machine learning programming languages, essentially, that make it possible for the AI researchers and practitioners, or people that actually know what they do, to build machine learning solutions without having to write all the maths or the differential equations that come into the picture. So we package that. The second thing is the machine learning platforms. So once you have the frameworks, you want to run that on a certain platform. And we provide Amazon SageMaker that I'm going to get into the details of to accelerate that process. And the Deep Lens, which is a developer-enabled camera that makes it possible for developers to build computer vision applications and prototype and test that right away. And at the top of the layers, we have cognitive services, what we call API services or AI services, that are essentially quick to access. You don't need to build anything. You throw a picture at Amazon Recognition, and it's going to give you an output of what it saw in the picture. And we do the same for vision, speech. We synthesize text into speech and speech into text. And for languages like translation and natural language processing, and for chatbot or call center applications in Amazon Lex, which is basically the brain of Alexa that we took out of the Echo device and we made available for people to consume or build their own applications. So we've been busy at AWS, and I know those layers seem very simple, but for the past 8 to 9 months, we've released up to 100 major features and services. So in the back end, really, what happens is that we're building all of these platforms, we're optimizing them, we're making sure that compliance kicks in, we're making sure that we get new packaging for things like TensorFlow or Hoverboard or Chainer, we're making sure that we're GDPR compliant, HIPAA compliant, and all the things that really have to happen in the back end so that as you build intelligent applications using Jupyter Notebooks, you don't have to worry about all of that. So you would rather have the icing on top of a cake and let somebody else eat the cake. Well, we'll eat the cake for you, right? So that's what we do. Now, what you have to do is to think about designing your machine learning experiments, as in building your machine learning models. And that's an iterative process. And typically, what you want to do is to take a subsample of your data set and then throw that at the Jupyter Notebook and then build iteratively until you have some kind of confidence in the algorithm that you want to use to solve your problem. And then you move to the process of training your algorithm on a larger scale data set. And that's a two-stage process. You have to train and tune your algorithms to make sure that you optimize hyperparameters to move from 92 to 95% accuracy, for example. And the next step is to deploy these algorithms in production, and a few factors come into play. Now, what we have for that is Amazon SageMaker, which is an end-to-end machine learning platform that enables data scientists, developers, AI researchers, practitioners, machine learning learners, everyone, essentially, to build, train, tune, and then deploy machine learning models at scale. And that lives on top of the fastest GPU infrastructure in the world. That's NVIDIA Voltage V100 GPU chips that have about 5,120 GPU cores. So that's an incredible infrastructure and an incredible packaging of machine learning software libraries, all available behind an API. And that's the kind of technology that enables a customer like Grammarly. You probably use Grammarly as you, you know, write text on the web or anywhere else, to build TensorFlow-based machine learning model for grammar correction in 8 minutes on top of a machine learning platform. So incredibly fast, again, momentum, ability to just accelerate. Now, the way things look like internally for SageMaker is that we have pre-built Jupyter Notebooks. We make Jupyter Notebooks available on top of an interface for you to just get started and then build your machine learning algorithms. We also have built-in high-performance algorithms that enable a certain amount of scale. And I'll get into the details of that later. The second thing is that there's an API for just calling the backend to train and tune your machine learning models, as well as hyperparameter optimization. And there's also an API to essentially deploy and scale your machine learning algorithms. Now, all of this environment is fully managed. It's a pay-as-you-go model. We support metadata for compliance and all these other things. So it's not just the platform. It's all the enterprise requirements that come into the picture. And that's what enables us to work with customers like Celgene that operate in the healthcare environment. And then so they have to be HIPAA compliant. And they use SageMaker today to dramatically accelerate the process by which they analyze drugs for toxicity level. Toxicity, I can't say that word right. So essentially, that's what they do. Right, so, and to jump back into the reproducibility aspect, so you have to package things like templates and machine learning examples and software development kits. What we have on SageMaker for that is a list of algorithms that were built by the Amazon team for the most common problems that people would have today. Things like object detection, text classification, multi-class classification, and even our own time series forecasting algorithm that can analyze up to 100,000 concurrent time series are made available within the platform. And these are some of the principles that we designed these algorithms for. 10 times faster, they have to work on a stream of data so that you don't have to upload the entire data set into a machine in order to process your algorithm. You need to be able to checkpoint that so that you can restart a job after from where you stopped the last time you trained an algorithm. And all of them have to be available behind an API. And so if you want to think about the Jupyter notebooks that we made available for that, we have tons of examples in the SageMaker platform that enable our customers to just essentially use these algorithms with our example data sets, take our data out of the platform, bring their own data, and solve their own problems from that. So really, really powerful. Now, to dig a little deeper into the algorithm, this is what the process would look like typically. So the yellow arrow there is my way of representing fast data coming to the platform, and the white one is for the cold data. So essentially, you would have data flying into your platform, and you probably have a data lake or a data store somewhere. Then you would use an algorithm to generate a model out of training the algorithm on top of your data, and then that would give you the model. And then you would pass new data to the model and get predictions out of that. Now, assuming that you want to analyze a customer activity, you probably want to use XGBoost to essentially generate customer segments, and then you pass a new customer to the model, you get the segments from that customer. If you want to do recommender systems for your customer, then you would use user profiles and purchase history and pass that through an algorithm called factorization machine. You get the model, new user, recommended products. So within SageMaker, we package all of these algorithms, and we made them, and many of them are open source algorithms. We just make sure that they are available behind a single click. XGBoost, K-nearest neighbor, principal component analysis, LSTMs, recommender systems, topic modeling for NLP, you name it. So there's a whole list of algorithms within the platform. And what your team needs to do is, using the Jupyter Notebook, explore our examples, get familiar with those algorithms, read the documentation, take our data out of it, bring your own data, and solve your own problems. And I can't tell you how many production-based products I've seen coming out of these algorithms just by following the examples. Now, the next thing is our customers told us, well, we like the Amazon algorithms, and they're fast and everything, but how can we make our own algorithms as fast as the machine learning algorithms provided by Amazon and SageMaker? Well, that's something that you can do with a lot of engineering and writing a lot of C++ backend codes, but we've done that for you. So as of recently, we announced Amazon SageMaker streaming algorithms, which is basically a mechanism to replicate what we do to accelerate your own algorithms by streaming large volumes of data, training data from Amazon S3 into SageMaker. And the way that works is that you were streaming your data, so we tricked the platform into thinking that it's seeing the entire data set, when actually it's seeing the data going through the platform, and your training can start faster, your training can take less time, and because time is money on the cloud, you're actually saving a lot of money. And what we see, so today it's available for TensorFlow, and soon it's going to be available for many other frameworks. Customer like Snap analyzes lots of images, and then they really pushed us on this feature, so we had to make that available for them and for most of you. So the last quick thing I'm going to talk about is the momentum. And to get on the momentum, I want to talk about production applications. So where do you run your application for essentially production workload? So to recap really quickly, we spoke about the platforms, the frameworks, and training your own algorithms or optimizing your own algorithms and Amazon SageMaker-provided algorithms. But what about a hosting story? So, well, we provide an environment to host machine learning model and do fancy things like A/B testing. And that environment today was okay for real-time processing, and then you could use the API endpoint. We would do auto-scaling in the back end to make sure that you have the infrastructure that is required to run your models at scale. But the other thing is, what if you had inventory data from last month that you wanted to analyze as a batch process? Or what if you have large files like 5K, you know, video files, and then you didn't really want to use a real-time API to use that? So what we've announced recently is Amazon SageMaker Batch Transform, which is essentially a way to use SageMaker for batch transformation or batch scoring of large amounts of data, fully managed and high-throughput batch transformation coming directly from Amazon S3 with a single API call. And the way this works is that you would provide you a large amount of data through Amazon SageMaker Batch Transform, and it's the same data set that could be used for testing and validating your models that could also be used for batch transformation. So what we see is that a lot of customers are using that environment for the validation stage of their models or for retraining or for scoring of the same models at the end of a month or at the end of a certain period that works for them. So all of these together enable what I call the momentum. And to illustrate that with an example, Intuit is a customer that routinely deploys machine learning models. And traditionally, it used to take them about 6 months to deploy a machine learning model. Now, with all the features for rapid training and rapid deployment, batch transformation, and all the auto-scaling and all the back-end operations that are taken care of by us, they can now deploy in 1 week. So this is my last slide about the entire ecosystem. The last thing I want to call out is that the machine learning platform and API services at AWS really live within an ecosystem. They live with the data lake storage and the compute capability and all the security and compliance and analytics tool all plug into this ecosystem to give you one entire machine learning capability. So with that, my time is up. Thanks a lot for having me. I'll see you at the booth for further conversations. Thank you.